come, O Lord our God.
And that 40th day when Jesus goes public, that is the formal end of our Christmas season. But since Easter is so late, there's one more Sunday of Epiphany season after that, and then after Mass next week, if anybody would like, all of these poinsettias need to go home so we don't have to throw them away, which is kind of a sad sight in all those garbage bags. So we got one more Sunday after this where we're still celebrating the Nativity of our Lord. So as we do gather as God's people at this time in his house, I ask you to please make a private examination of your conscience. And may we now recite the Confiteor together. I confess, Almighty God, one in the Holy Trinity, who knows the innermost secrets of my heart, that I have sinned in thought, word, and deed, by my fault, by my own great fault. In your presence, O God, I publicly express sorrow for the many sins by which I have offended you. I resolve to amend my life, to improve and sanctify, endeavoring henceforth to serve you faithfully all the days of my life. I ask all those who dwell within the Church of Christ, the Blessed Mother Mary, the Holy Apostles, Martyrs, and Faithful, who have lived, suffered, and died for the gospel of Jesus Christ, as well as you, my brothers and sisters, to witness my confession
and pray for me
to our Lord God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant us pardon, absolution, and remission of our sins. May our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all your sins, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Show us your mercy, Lord.
And
Lord, hear our prayer.
And you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Grant, most gracious Father, that of purity of heart, we may worthily fulfill this holy action, established in remembrance of the Last Supper and the death of Jesus Christ, and for our sanctification and salvation. Be present among us, Jesus, our most perfect Master, because you said that where two or three are gathered together in my name, you are among them. We also ask, Lord, that through this holy liturgy, we may experience a spiritual revival and a better understanding of your holy will, bringing us together in one great family, guided by your commandments and by love, truth, and justice. And may we say together, let us pray for the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, indivisible, revealed in triune power for all time, now, and forever.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord our God, you have established the standards whereby we should live our lives. Forgive us for adopting the standards of the world instead, which only betray you and our very nature. Cause us to delight in your word, that we may indeed be blessed. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
By the Church for this morning's Holy Mass is taken from 1 Corinthians. Consider your own call, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in the world, things that are not, to reduce to nothing things that are, so that no one might boast in the presence of God. He is the source of your life in Jesus Christ, who became for us wisdom from God, and righteousness and sanctification and redemption, in that order, as it is written. Let the one who boasts, boast in the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord guides the humble rightly and teaches the humble the way. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are those who fear the Lord, greatly delight in God's command. Cleanse my heart and my lips, Almighty God, you cleanse the lips of the prophet Isaiah with a burning coal. In your mercy, cleanse me so I may worthily proclaim your holy gospel through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Lord be in my heart and on my lips, that I may worthily proclaim his holy gospel. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him, and he began to teach them by saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. For thus they persecuted the prophets, the ones who came before you." This is the gospel of the Lord.
There were no problems.
no problems at all. And after I donated, I went over and I started talking to Jack Cooper, who's from town. And that's when that very nice, very concerned nurse came over and finally gave me my $5 Dunkin' Donuts coupon for donating that she forgot to give me with all the commotion. And Jack says to her that maybe I should get two for all the trouble that I just gone through, and I've just got the one anyway. When the Red Cross called the next day, which the nurse said that they probably would do because of all the stuff that had just happened, I answered, and you got caller ID, so I answered the phone, and I apologized for answering but taking so long to get there, because I said I was dragging this heavy dead arm behind me. The woman on the phone got all excited, all nervous, and that's when I had to tell her, no, I'm just kidding, everything is just fine. But I guarantee that if this had happened when I was back in college, and I was just starting to donate blood for the first time, this would have freaked me out, even if the nurse said, don't freak out. I would have been seeing my arm grow fatter and fatter and fatter, even if no change at all had taken place. I would have seen my poor little hand turning bluer and bluer, even if no change had ever been taking place. Experience makes a world of difference, and it's experience that Paul calls upon when he writes to the Corinthians in today's reading. He begins this morning's selection by telling the members of that early church community, consider your own call. In other words, think about your own experience. And when he sends them down that road, he gets them to start realizing that it wasn't about how prepared they were, about how moral they were, how many good things they had done. And this leads him to conclude with the statement that no one, saint, sinner, no one can boast in the presence of God. None of us deserves anything that God gives us. All we can do is trust that God loves us no matter what. And this prepares the congregation to start thinking differently, gets them to realize the central importance of Jesus in their lives. It is Jesus that we must boast about, says Paul to the Corinthians, and it is Jesus that Paul says to us today we must boast about. He's the one who can make the unbearable bearable. He's the one who can make the impossible possible. Life can be hard. We all know life can be hard. But Jesus is stronger. Boast in him, says Paul. Think back to this morning's gospel as well. It was the reading of the Beatitudes. Now, blessings are not defined by Jesus in the ways that a lot of people may expect blessings from God to be defined. There are some preachers today who are even insisting that prosperity is a definition of being blessed. And I don't know where in the world they find that in the New Testament. But the Beatitudes, they are the first preachings of Jesus to the crowds. This is Jesus' introduction to his world. This is Christianity 101, and they are anything but what a normal person would expect as blessings. It's not blessed are the rich, not blessed are the connected, not blessed are the healthy. Instead, Jesus says in Christianity 101, blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who mourn, he says. Blessed are the meek. Blessed are the righteous, the merciful, the pure, the peacemakers, and even blessed are the persecuted. Jesus holds these unexpected traits up as blessings because they give evidence that blessings are not seen only as the things that we have right now. The blessings that we receive from God have the ability to see that Jesus walks right beside us, that we really, sincerely, honestly, concretely feel the presence of Jesus beside us, and that we also trust that eternity is for real, that this doesn't define everything about who we are. To be among the blessed in this way is to be stronger than we could ever hope to be on our own, and this is why, says St. Paul, consider your own calling. The experience of Jesus, it changes everything. One of our parishioners shared with me an interview with an author and a public speaker, and he mentioned that one of the vulnerabilities of people today is an addiction to technology. It has left too many people too often unable to build relationships, and it leaves them lacking with coping mechanisms when things get tough. You know, they're not prepared to handle the difficult and the unexpected and outright failure because they don't have personal experience to rely on. You can only get so much out of a machine. And when you only turn to the machine for your kind of sense of well-being and meaning in the world, well, it's just not going to be enough, they're finding out. And he was speaking to young people. The Beatitudes lay out a faith that can only be based on the experience of Jesus in our lives. And Paul, that first generation pastor, says, consider your own experience. If we don't feel Jesus near, if we don't have a personal relationship with Jesus, we don't have anything to draw. It's like that person who can just turn to the phone or just turn to the internet, and they're going to find out when things get really hard. That's not enough. We have to make a personal relationship with Jesus. And this means that faith is not the content of what we believe. Faith is our relationship with Christ. And relationships, they take work and they take time. It means actually coming to church. And I've got to talk about that because since Christmas, our attendance has been embarrassing. There are people, that faithful people, that come here every Sunday, and thank God they do. But there are people that come and they go like this is only just something you do, you know, like for fun. It's not really about relationship. It's not needing Jesus. And take a look around. Is this the kind of church that we want to have? Or are we supposed to do something else so we can go out and speak for Jesus? Are we brave enough to say to somebody, why don't you come back to church? Why don't you try this? Or what is missing in church that you don't want to come? I'm not into scaring people into church. I don't believe that if you don't go to church, you're going to go to hell. But what is it about church that offers something to somebody that they want to be here? And why are they not coming ever since we announced the birth of Jesus? What is it about the celebration of Jesus that brought them here? And then they can forget. So relationship, that experience with Christ, is what we have to have in our lives. And we're not doing this if we don't understand why 1 hour a week we need to be in His house, in His presence, in His community. It means living and praying, singing and communion. It means all of those things that make Jesus real every single day. It means consistency. This here, right now, right what we're doing here, is one of the main parts of our experience of Christ. If we take this out of our lives, what else do we do to replace it? Do we really go out and work for some charity? Do we really go out and read the Bible and study for an hour? Do we really go out and pray in the woods? Or do we just find the excuse that I don't need to do that? Faith isn't like the polar plunge bear swimmer in and out of the water in a second. There was this wonderful kid when I used to go to the youth retreats from years back. He was from Westfield. And as soon as free time started, until the moment it ended, that kid was in that lake floating around. That's what faith has to be. Not the polar bear just proving that you can do it every once in a while and running out. It's that idea that you got to get in that water and stay in that water. Experience made a world of difference when the nurse hit my artery so that I didn't freak out. And also, experience make a world of difference when we get the unexpected and the unwanted in our lives, because experience will let us build a relationship with Jesus that we need to boast in none other. That we may be blessed with such a faith. For this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty and most merciful Lord, as we gather as your people this day before your altar, we offer our prayers for Stephen Asher, for a good outcome for his daughter, and this prayer is being offered by Bill and Teresa Girardi. We offer prayers in memory of Jean Wadsworth on the anniversary of her death, which was January 31st of 2012. Again, it is offered by Teresa and Bill Girardi. We continue to offer our prayers for those who are battling cancer. Meg Connors by Ellen and Don Swarovski. Brandy Clements by her grandmother, Dottie Baronas. Fathers Ray Trader, Maurice Lazelle, and also Bishop Thomas Gannat is offered by myself. Richard Poe is offered by the Poe and Foster families. Young Jack Seela is offered by Mariana Foster. We also offer our prayers for Alex, who is 16 years old with lymphoma Hodgkin's disease. Alicia, a young mother of three with stage 4 breast cancer, and Liz Bridgman, also with cancer, raising 3 young girls on her own. And those 3 final prayers are offered by Cindy Benjamin. And lastly, we offer our prayers for Frank Sprosky, is offered by his brother Don, Sprosky, Gage, and Kirkendall families. Are there any prayers that you'd like to offer from the congregation? Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much.
And I think that should be our prayer every week, that we're praying for the people to come back.
come back home. Yep, I think we should maybe make that more of a vocal prayer. Absolutely. Any other prayers? For all these prayers, Lord, plus the private ones that we bring before you now, we also ask you, Lord, to bless each and every one of us who is here, bless all of those for our parish who are unable to be with us here today, and of course, those for our parish who have chosen not to be with us here today. And for these things together, Lord, we pray by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. May she rest in peace.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I believe in one God,
the Father, and the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, but one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary, and he became man. For our sake, he was crucified on Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who receives from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Pursues justice and kindness will find life and will find honor. We receive from your most sacred hands, most gracious Father, the sacramental bread. With the same faith and trust that the apostles and disciples of your Son and our Savior, when he said to them, I myself am the bread.
Thank you.
ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Receive this offering, most holy Trinity, which we make in remembrance of the passion, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, in honor of Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, that may add to their honor and aid our salvation. May they whose memory we honor on earth intercede for us in heaven. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, the Father Almighty. Amen. Heavenly Father, as we offer you the sacrifice of the Mass, bless our altar with the presence of your Son. May we who receive him be changed in heart and become peaceful, compassionate, humble, just, and faithful people. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God. Forever and ever. Jesus Christ our Lord. You sent us Jesus Christ, who conceived by the Holy Spirit, was born of the Virgin Mother, Mary most holy. We have come to know and love you as our perfect Father through the revealed mystery of your incarnate Word. We praise you, Father, and through your Son now made visible, long to be with you, our unseen God. Therefore the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power, heaven and earth, full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We therefore, most merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, most humbly beseech you to accept and to bless these gifts, these presents, these holy, unspotted sacrifices, which your holy Church receives from you, imploring you to defend and guide her throughout the world, together with her priests and all true believers of the holy faith. Remember, Lord, your Church. This congregation, imbued with faith in your holy care, your rule and fatherly love, wholeheartedly this day, we unite in spirit with all of them, here the most blessed Mother Mary, Mother of Jesus Christ, likewise his apostles with all the countless hosts of martyrs and confessors who lived, labored, and suffered for the same holy cause which Jesus Christ sacrificed his life and his most precious blood, just as they believed, professed, and united with you through prayer and this immaculate oblation, which you have instituted from the beginning of the world, and in time have fulfilled through Jesus Christ, and gave it to humanity as a pledge of eternal salvation. So we too this day profess and unite ourselves with you, most gracious Father, in humbleness of spirit, and accept from your hands this holy bread and this precious chalice as a longed-for gift bestowed on us by the Savior of the world as spiritual food and drink. He promised us this food and drink in that moment when he revealed his divine power by the multiplication of bread, and feeding with it a hungry multitude of people. Afterward, he foretold the giving of that food and drink to his disciples and friends as a more excellent nourishment when he said, "It is my Father who gives you the real heavenly bread. I myself am the living bread come down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he shall live forever. The bread I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." And afterwards, from the temporal and messianic life of the divine teacher and giver of the covenant was drawing to a close, he gathered into the upper room all those who had loved in a singular way and had chosen to continue his work of salvation. He spoke to them words of deep love, longing, and resolve. "I will not leave you orphaned. I will come back to you." I am the way, the truth, and the life. You are my friends if you do what I command you. Do not be distressed or fearful. You will suffer in the world, but take courage. I have overcome the world. If you live in me, and my words stay a part of you, you may ask what you will, and it will be done for you. Anyone who loves me will be true to my word, and my Father will love him. We will come to him and make our dwelling place with him. I consecrate myself for their sakes now, that they may be consecrated in truth, that all may be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I in you. I pray that they may be one in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. I have given them the glory you gave me, that they may be one as we are one. I living in them, you living in me, that their unity may be made complete. Father, all those you gave me, I would have in my company where I am to see this glory of mine, which is your gift to me, because of the love you bore me before the world began. I myself am the bread of life. No one who comes to me shall ever be hungry. No one who believes in me shall ever thirst. After these and other words of the archpriest in prayer and with holy fervor, our Savior took bread into his holy and venerable hands, and having lifted his eyes to heaven, to you, his almighty Father, giving thanks to you, he blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you. Taking this excellent chalice into his holy and venerable hands, again giving thanks to you, he blessed it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, mindful Lord, we your servants and your faithful people, in remembrance of this Christ, your Son and our Lord, as well as his blessed passion, resurrection, and his glorious ascension, we receive from your own gifts and presents a pure offering, a holy offering, an immaculate offering, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. These gifts we receive with a joyful countenance, as from him who is the giver of all temporal and eternal good gifts, and with an unshakable faith that they will become for our souls a saving remedy. We humbly ask you, Almighty God, to command that our offering be brought by the hands of your holy angel to your highest altar, into the presence of your divine majesty. That we, who receive the most sacred body and blood of your Son from this altar, may be filled with every blessing and grace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, passed on to eternity. To these souls, Lord, and to all who rest in Christ, grant everlasting life, and to those who are in life straight in the path of righteousness, unmindful of your fatherly love, mercifully shorten their sufferings. We ask this in the name of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And grant us, your sinful servants, who hope in the greatness of your mercy, some part in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs and all your saints, who shed their blood for your name. Their hearts were always open to justice and mercy, and with lives patterned after their divine master, merited eternal joy. Number us in their company, Lord, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. By whom you always create, sanctify, revive, bless, and freely give us all these good things. Through him, and with him, and in him, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. Forever and ever. Instructed by our Savior's teaching and following divine example, we say with confidence, Amen.
Lord from all evils, past, present, and future, and by the intercession of the blessed and glorious Mother of God, Mary, together your blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, as also Andrew and all the saints, grant us peace in our days, supported by the help of your mercy, that we always be free from sin and secure from all disturbance. Through the same, Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life. Amen. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom. You live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching, and never let me be parted from you, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. May the partaking of your body and blood, Lord Jesus, not be cause for my judgment. Though I am unworthy to receive this great sacrament, through your loving kindness may it become my safeguard and healing remedy. My saving master, awaken in me a living faith, fervent love, worship, adoration, and a holy longing. Through this communion, make me your willing servant, zealous to fulfill your holy will. May it last and I be entirely with you, my Lord and my God. Grant this who lives, reigns with God the Father, and you with the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen. I will take the bread of heaven, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. May the body of our Lord Jesus Christ bring me to everlasting life. Amen. Which I return to the Lord for all the graces that he has given me. I will take the chalice of salvation, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. With high praise will I call upon the Lord, and I shall be saved from all my enemies. May the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring me to life everlasting. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Body and the blood of Christ. body and the blood of Christ.
Through this Holy Eucharist, to begin all of our tasks with reverence,
to continue them in obedience, and to finish them in charity. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Sacrifice
is offered.
Thanks be to God.
May the tribute of our worship be pleasing to you, most holy Trinity. Grant that the sacrifice which I, though unworthy, have offered the sight of your majesty be acceptable to you, through your mercy may be effective for myself and all of those for whom I have offered it, through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the almighty and merciful God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was in God's presence, and the Word was God. He was present to God in the beginning. Through him all things came into being, and apart from him nothing came to be. Whatever came to be in him found life, life in the light of men. The light shines on in darkness, a darkness that did not overcome it. There was a man named John sent by God who came as a witness to testify to the light so that through him all might believe, but only to testify to the light, for he himself was not the light. The real light which gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and through him the world was made, yet the world did not know who he was. To his own he came, yet his own did not accept him. And he who did accept him, he empowered to become children of God. These are they who believe in his name, who were begotten not by blood, nor by carnal desire, nor by man's willingness, but by God. And the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of an only Son coming from the Father, filled with enduring love.